What makes up the National Junior Honor Society?
Service. Leadership.
Character. Citizenship.
Scholarship. Scholarship represents a commitment to learning. It means a student is committed to their academics and understands the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind. As students, we should continue to learn even when our formal education has ended. For education is ongoing and never ending. Knowledge is one great element in life that leads to high success. And it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning lights the lamp by which we read the past, the torch that guides us to understand the present, and the promise that illuminates the future. Our candidates have demonstrated the highest levels of scholarship and have the responsibility to continually expand the world through the opportunities inherent in scholarship.
Service. Service is established or rise to help others both at school and in the community. A willingness to work for the benefit of those in need. Without monetary compensation or public recognition is the quality we seek in our membership and promote for the entire student body. We are committed to volunteering our time and talents of the creation of a better tomorrow. Our current members and our new inductees are committed to serving the National Junior Honor Society, our school, and the Long Branch community.
Leadership. Leadership should exert a wholesome influence on the school. In taking initiative in the classroom and in school activities, the real leader strives to coach and aid others to reach success. The price of leadership is a sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interests for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power and resources may exist in a school, community, or nation, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed. Thus, to lead is meaningful and substantive charge to each of our current and newest members of the National Junior Honor Society.
Character. Character is the force within the individual that distinguishes each person from others. It creates for each of us our individuality, our goodness. Without character, no one can respect oneself nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character that guides one through life and once developed, grows steadily within. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant thought and action, the daily striving to make the right choice, no matter how challenging that may be. We must be in reality what we wish to appear to others to be rather than to seem. By demonstrating such qualities as respect, responsibility, trustworthiness, fairness, caring, and citizenship, the Njhs hopes to prove by our example that we value character.
Citizenship. I represent citizenship. The obligation that each member of our society faces to live up to the democratic ideals that guide our country. There are many responsibilities each of us has to our home, community, state, nation, and world. As good citizens, we are bound to live up to the laws and guidelines that unite us. Good citizens work together to improve not only our lives, but the lives of all our fellow citizens. Good citizenship requires that we remain strong and vigilant in protecting the freedoms and rights that have been granted to us and in preventing injustice from entering our lives. We, the chapter members, are called to live up to the high standards of citizenship from this day forward.
Leonardo Arcos. I would like to thank my parents and my family. My parents have always pushed me to do wonderful things and be a better person. They have taught me to learn from my mistakes and keep pushing forward. In addition to that, I would like to thank the rest of my family for always supporting me. Being inducted into such a prestigious organization is an amazing accomplishment, and I wouldn't be here without the help of my teachers and my coaches as well.
Juliet Abiel. First, I'd like to thank both my parents for their support, but specifically my mom. My mom is my inspiration and role model because of how hard she works, and that inspires me to work hard in what I do. She has been by my side my entire life and has been there with me through everything. She has supported and believed in me in everything I do. Without her, I wouldn't be here. Her support motivated me to exceed my limits in everything. I would also like to thank everyone that was involved with this whole process for me to be here as a new member. Lastly, I would like to thank Mr. DeAngelis for presenting me the opportunity to be a part of the Njhs.
Sophia Gutman, I would like to take a moment to express my sincerest appreciation to each and every member of my family for their amazing support and encouragement throughout my life. Their love and guidance have been a constant source of strength and motivation for me. I would like to extend my heartfelt gratitude to my close friends and all the teachers and principals from both USA and Brazil who have had a significant impact on my life. Your tireless efforts have helped me shape into the person I am today. From my first day of kindergarten to my final year of elementary school, they taught me valuable lessons that I will carry with me for the rest of my life. I would like to express a ton of gratitude to my parents who have always helped me with everything. Love y'all.
Victoria Barbosa. First, I wanted to start off by thanking my parents for all the support and love they had for me. Without their support, I wouldn't have somebody guiding me to my goals. They inspired me to be the best version of myself, and I also want to thank my sister for always encouraging me, giving me advice, and guiding me to good decisions like this one. Lastly, I would like to thank Mr. DeAngelis for providing me with this opportunity to be an Njhs.
Angelina Bontemple. First, I'd like to thank my parents. They've been on my side my entire life and helped me through my most challenging times. Without their support, I probably wouldn't be here. My best friends, Gabe and Sophia, have been supporting me through all my ups and downs over the past few years. They motivated me to keep up my grades in school and be more involved in my community, and they helped me turn into a better version of myself. I would also like to thank Mr. DeAngelis for allowing me to be a part of the Njhs.
Carter Brown. I'd like to thank my family for whenever I stuck or needed guidance. I appreciate all their sacrifices for me, and I can't even put everything they've done into words. If they hadn't supported me in this way, I likely would still be wondering what life as an Njhs member is like. I thank my dad for helping me to look ahead to the future. I also thank my brother Christian for always giving me a spice in my day. I appreciate my mom for constantly making my day when I come home, making sure I was okay, and growing up, I will never forget these gifts.
Isabella Camargos. I would like to thank my parents, specifically my mom, who has been my number one supporter and has been by my side my entire life. She has helped me through my most challenging times and has always believed in me. Without their support, I probably wouldn't be where I am today. I would also like to thank my best friends, Tabitha and Yasmin, for believing in me and encouraging me to do my best. They have helped me become the better version of myself, and I'm very thankful for that. Lastly, I would like to thank Mr. DeAngelis for giving me the opportunity to be a part of the Njhs.
Dana Chavez Sanchez. I'd like to thank my parents for always guiding me through the right path and always supporting me during my middle school years. Acknowledging the sacrifices they made, the compassion I have for them is really strong. The advice they always give me, I know that my parents are trying their absolute hardest to make me a better person, reminding me to keep following the right path filled with the hopes I have, and especially help me realize that I'll have a better life ahead of me, which is why they've always kept me motivated in my academics and be more productive by taking the opportunity of participating in school activities and help me be involved in the community. Their significance truly impacted me beneficially that I find them as my role models. I'm grateful to have them, and if it weren't for them, I wouldn't have the potential to be the person I am today.
Isabella Colmenares. Good evening, everyone.
Primero que nada, quiero agradecer a mis padres por apoyarme siempre. Quiero agradecer a mis maestros por todo lo que me han enseñado. Y sobre todo quiero agradecer a Mr. D'Angelo and his team por brindarme esta gran oportunidad de unirme a National Junior Honor Society.
I would like to thank my parents, sisters, uncle, and other family members for always being there for me. First, I want to start off with my mom. She has always been there for me, supporting me, and made me who I am today. She was there for me when I was having my bad and good days, even when I didn't know I needed her. My mom makes me want to become the best person I can be in school and out of school. Even when we didn't have a lot, she always made sure we could have the best. I would also like to thank the teachers, especially Mr. D'Angelo, who helped my middle school experience improve for the better, who are always there for me, and who got me to where I am today.
Layla Dacher, I would like to take a moment to give thanks to the people who supported me. First is my mother. She always makes me smile through the roughest days. She always has been there for me and stood up for me when no one else would. She is the best mother I could ask for. I would also like to thank my father. Whenever I'm with him, he always makes me laugh. One of our favorite activities to do together is shopping, and I always look forward to it. Love you, Dad. I would like to thank Lbms for always providing excellent opportunities for me to try new things, and all of my teachers for always being there to help and guide me when I need it. I'm also very thankful for the custodians in our building for keeping it clean. Finally, I would like to thank Mr. D'Angelo for accepting me into the Njhs.
Anna DeSantana. First, I would like to thank my mother for always being there for me. Every time I could conclude a play, I looked down and smiled at both of my parents for their dedication to attending my performances and encouraging me. Secondly, I would like to thank my guitar and singing teachers for their constant support and commitment to me. I would also like to thank my teacher who wrote my recommendation letter because she brightens my day and I look forward to seeing her. I would also like to thank my sister. She is my inspiration to become the person I am. And lastly, I would also like to thank Mr. D'Angelo for giving me the opportunity to be here.
Princess Savan Diala. Firstly, I'd like to thank all of my family members for always being there for me throughout my entire life, especially my mom and older brother. Without their encouragement and helpful advice, I wouldn't be as successful as I am now. Their leadership and guidance have helped me through everything I've been through, good and bad, and for that, I'm thankful. Next, I'd like to thank all of my astounding friends, old and new, who have made me strong and open-minded as I am today. The comfort and reassurance is another thing that has made me the person I am now, and I appreciate all of them. I'd also like to thank all the amazing Lbms teachers and staff who have motivated me to rise to difficult challenges and try new things that I've never done before. They've all impacted me in positive ways, and I cannot thank them enough. Finally, I'd like to thank the Njhs community, especially Mr. D'Angelo, for giving me the opportunity to be a part of Njhs and getting me where I'm at today.
LaShawn Fitch. First, I would like to thank everyone who's had my back and has believed in me, always keeping my best interests at heart. But I would like to give a special thanks to my mom for being amazing and supporting me in all my interests. Through her support, she has set me up for success. She also got me involved in wonderful community organizations such as Jacob's Ladder. Lastly, I would like to thank one more person, and that would be the one and only Mr. D'Angelo. He has always believed in me and pushed me to do my best, whether it be on the mats or in the classroom. He has always made me feel like family, and I'll never forget that. Thank you.
Yaya Hassan. First and foremost, I'd like to thank everyone who's supporting me in joining Njhs. Specifically, I'd like to thank my mother for building the foundation that I later start in life, and my father for motivating me and always being by my side. Also, I'd like to thank my brother and my sister because they have always been my role models. They would always express to me how important NJHS is, which piqued my interest in it. Lastly, I'd like to thank my teachers for motivating me and putting pressure on me so I did not slack off. This helped me make the student I am today. NJHS is a highly respected group of students, and it is an honor to be a member.
Iman Irfan, I want to thank my parents, my mom for pushing me when I was feeling unmotivated and putting in all the effort to get me where I am, and my dad for always putting a smile on my face, helping me and not only being a great dad, but a great friend. I would also like to thank my teachers and most of all my sister, who is not with us today, but she was the kindest person I've ever met. She was always there for me and with me during the good times and the worst times of my life. I am eternally grateful for everyone who helped me through this journey.
Kaylin Jones Moraes. First, I would like to thank God for blessing me with this opportunity, my parents. However, my mom has always supported me and is a day one, as I wouldn't be here without her. I would also like to thank every single one of my friends and teammates, as they kept me on my toes no matter what. But my best friends have been the biggest inspiration to me ever, as they are intelligent, hardworking, persevering, and everything above that. And yes, that includes my sister. Last, I would like to thank all of my coaches, teachers, family, and Mr. DeAngelis for helping me get here. Without any of these people mentioned, I would never be here.
Braylon Jones. First, I would like to thank God because without him, nothing is possible. Then, I would like to thank my mom, grandma, and aunt because they have always been there for me and supported me no matter what. Third, I would like to thank the two teachers that wrote my letters of recommendation, Ms. Joyce and Ms. Battaglia, for always pushing me to do my best in their classes. Lastly, I would like to thank everyone who signed my candidate form and Mr. DeAngelis for giving me the opportunity to be a part of the NJHS. If it weren't for these people that helped me in my journey, I wouldn't be here at this ceremony today.
Kaoi Lopez Cano, I would like to thank first God for making this special moment for me possible and my mom and dad for everything they have done for me, for not ever giving up on me and always supporting me no matter the situation. I would like to thank my little sister Kaori. Kaori has Dravet syndrome, which is a type of epilepsy that affects her brain and giving her constant seizures. Since she was born, we had to spend a significant amount of time in the hospital with her, and through this family battle, she has taught me and my parents what strength looks like in many extremely difficult situations, situations where others would simply just give up. I would like to thank all the people I met throughout the time, like the nurses and therapists of FRA, who have educated me about my sister's diagnosis and inspired me to push myself and learn as much as I can, so that I can provide her with everything she may need in the future. Lastly, I would like to thank my little brother, Byron. Byron was diagnosed with autism, a condition we did not realize he had when he was born. Through this discovery, I truly felt that the need to put my education first again, because again, in the future, I want to be able to help him with anything he's going to need, and the only way to do this is truly succeeding in school and obtaining a good job. My sister and brother are the two most important people in my life and will always be my motivation for everything I do.
Delilah Martinez. First, I would like to thank the Long Branch Middle School and its staff for giving me this opportunity to be a part of such a talented group and allowing me to grow. I want to thank God for giving me this blessing and granting me the materials I needed to be able to achieve this role. I want to thank my mom, who has always been there for me along the way. No matter how late I stayed up doing my work, she's always told me to follow my dreams and made me feel special. She's the reason why I shine bright. For my sisters, even though you didn't have anything to do with my academics, I thank you guys for always making me laugh when school got stressful. To my stepdad, thank you for always being there to keep me in shape, making sure I had everything I needed. Thank you to my grandparents, who always kept me on my toes and spoiled me with love and support. From the bottom of my heart, I thank everyone in my family who has ever supported me. Whether your name was mentioned or not, your support does not go unnoticed.
Eliana Mendoza. First, I would like to thank my teachers throughout middle school for pushing me to be the best and making sure I was comfortable in and out of the classroom. I especially want to thank Mr. DeAngelis for working with me to be a part of the NJHS since 6th grade. I would also like to thank my mom for making sure I was always caught up with all my schoolwork and responsibilities. She is a wonderful mother and I love her with all my heart. I would like to thank my father for always being there for me and making sure I was okay in school. He has always encouraged me to make the right decisions. Lastly, I would like to thank all my wonderful friends I have made here at Lbms. They are always pushing me to do my best and I am so lucky to have them all in my life.
Rebecca Mandora Aguilar. To begin, I would like to thank my family and friends. They have always supported me and have been there for me. However, I would like to thank my mom and sister especially. My mom has always been there to take care of me. Her bravery and hard work has always been an example to keep going and to be the best person I can be. My sister Rachel has always been a role model for me and always challenged me to set high goals for myself. Even when I'm ready to give up, she has always been there to help and push me. Without them, I would have never had the courage to try. Thanks to them, I'm here today being accepted to NJHS.
Avery Montgomery, if it weren't for my parents that gave me the motivation to carry on my goal to be a part of NJHS, I probably wouldn't be a part of this wonderful group. I would also like to thank my good friends for also giving me the support to carry on my goal. My mom and dad have stuck with me my whole life, giving me the courage, motivation, and support I need to do great in school and around my community. I also want to thank my grandfather for also pushing me to do what I have to do. My grandfather is also my inspiration to keep going and never to give up. Without him being a part of my life and my school journey, I probably wouldn't have the courage to join NJHS. Therefore, I want to thank all the people who gave me the love, motivation, and support to join the National Junior Honor Society.
Sofia Nunez Garcia Leon. I would like to thank both my parents for supporting me throughout my whole life and providing me with the opportunity into being in the school and getting into NJHS. Without parents like them, I don't know where I'd be in life. Both my best friends, Angel and Gabe, have been by my side through any hard times, also pushed me to challenge myself to apply for NJHS. I would also like to thank my best friend, Anna, who I met in third grade and has helped me through any hard times. I truly enjoy her company. Also, thank you to my brother and cousin, who have always been there for me and hopefully will always be a part of my life. I am so thankful for all of them in supporting me into getting into NJHS.
Vinicius Oliveira Alves. First of all, I would like to thank my mom, dad, and sister for always being there for me. I would also like to thank them for always supporting me. Second of all, I want to thank the rest of my family members here tonight for cheering me on when I was going through rough times. I would also like to thank all of my teachers. If it weren't for them, I wouldn't be part of the National Junior Honor Society and here at the ceremony tonight.
Jacqueline Robidon. First, I'd like to thank my parents for always supporting me and cheering me on during the toughest times of my middle school career. They were and will continue to be my biggest motivation for doing well in school and focusing on my grades. I would also like to thank my sisters for giving me the best advice anyone could ever give. They always make sure that I'm the best version of myself no matter what. Most importantly, thank you to my closest friends who always find various ways to make me content and laugh. They've always been there for me in every good and bad situation. I wouldn't have any special middle school memories if it weren't for all of them. Because of them, I have something to look forward to every day. Lastly, I'd like to thank Mr. DeAngelis for presenting me with this opportunity to be a part of the NJHS and making me believe that I'm capable of doing anything. He always makes sure that I'm smiling and not stressed. Thank you to everyone who has helped me get through 6th, 7th, and 8th grade.
Sophia Ribeiro Mendoza. First, I would like to thank my family for always being there for me and helping me with everything they can. I would like to especially thank my mom and sister for always supporting and believing in me. They helped me during the most challenging times and would always encourage me to do better. They are my biggest inspiration, and without them, I wouldn't be where I am today. I would like to thank my dad for being the best dad out there and motivating me all the time. I would like to thank my brother-in-law for being so brave and encouraging me to be brave as well. I would like to thank my friends for helping me throughout the whole process and being so accommodating. I would sincerely like to thank Ms. Krishnas for writing my recommendation letter and being such a great and helpful teacher. Finally, I would like to thank Mr. DeAngelis for giving me the chance to be a new member of the NJHS.
Samuel Rodriguez Carpio. To begin, I would like to thank my parents because they've always been there for me and raised me in an environment that showed me if I want to achieve something in life, I can't give up on it. I just have to keep trying. I also want to thank my aunt because she has played a significant role in getting me into this position. She allowed me to volunteer where she worked and gave me a chance to participate in the National Junior Honor Society. She may not be here tonight, but I want to thank her anyway. My mom always told me that all the work that I put in will pay off, just like how I made it to the NJHS. Lastly, I would like to thank my teachers for always pushing me in a way that I can get stronger at what I do academically. And it has helped me reach where I am today. I am very grateful for everybody who stood by my side throughout my journey.
Jonathan Santos. To begin, I would like to thank my parents for always pushing me to do the best I can. They're always there when I need them, even when I make mistakes. They are my rock and always just lending a helping hand. They are great role models because they set high expectations for me and help me achieve them. I love you, Mom and Dad. Words will never be enough to express my gratitude for all the love and care you've shown me. I would also like to thank Mrs. Richardson, Mrs. DeGraw, and Ms. James for believing me and recommending me to the NJHS. Lastly, a huge thank you to Mr. DeAngelis for giving me the chance to join this amazing society.
I make up National Junior Honor Society.
We are the LBMS National Junior Honor Society.